Hey friends, welcome back to the video. So sitting at 46 USD and 27 C dollars now. So roughly about, what would you say, probably about $73 bankroll at the moment. Probably the worst day yesterday since we've started was yesterday, but we tried 5NL. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do 5NL, but I'm only going to do C dollars, and if we ran out of the C dollars, we'll definitely call it quits, and then go back to 2NL. But we're just going to four table it today and then go from there. It sounds a bit crazy, it might be, but I just want to try and get to, I just want to hit that mark. Just going to do the cash and run, going to go five, going to do four tables here today, just to be a bit more easier to focus as well. Also, what we can do, what I'm going to do, I'm going to tile it first. Hold on a sec, going to sit out just for a little bit. What I'm going to do, got some hands here that I could steal with. But what I'm going to do is, I'm going to play around with this for a little bit. So, alright, so what are we doing? I'm going to actually play around with this. I'm going to fix the range up to the way I want to play. So King 8's gone. We could probably 3-bet out of position with ace 2. This is just a bluff. Just going to run a bluff here, and he just folds. Okay, sweet. So small blind definitely going to be playing around a little bit more, especially against the big blind, because what you guys say is defend more from the big blind. So what does that tell us? It tells us that people from the big blind are going to be a lot wider than they need to be. So we can actually bluff them off a lot of hands. Okay, so what are we doing? So we can actually mark down. I'm going to mark down everything I want to do here. I actually don't like ace 10 offsuit. All right, so these hands are gone. It's going to seem really tight, guys. All right. So we're going to do it. This is going to be it, I think. This is going to be the mark. We could probably throw a couple of suited connectors in. Preferably not as well. So at this stage, I'm just having to play around with it. Whether or not we have these suited connectors, I don't think so. Jack 9 suited. Actually, I'm going to get rid of those hands. Queen 10 suited, King 10 suited. I really don't like Queen 10 suited, but I'm going to apply it anyway. Do not fold on the dealer button, and do not fold from the blind. So then this is what we're going to be, anything in the black is what we're folding from under the gun and, you know, cut off and hijack. And everything else is what we'll decide. We could still play from other positions. Okay, so we can, this is what we're doing. I've never done this before, but this is what we're going to do. Let's have a look and see what happens. All right, guys. All right, so we're in the blinds there. So obviously it's not going to auto fold. All right, so far so good. All right, got pocket 10s, which is nice. Took away ace 10, which is fine as well. I guess we're jamming against the 3-bet here. No. Yeah, we can jam against big blind, I guess. All right, it gets the button. It gets the button with 3-betting here, which is fine. King Jack is dead now. Got a bet here. We've hit a 5. We've got a diamond as well. Win the hand. That's fine. King Jack just no luck there. Got a flat. Jack 10 suited in out of position, but we hit top pair, which is nice. He could be floating with overcards here. All right, so we're going to check there. I guess we could have done a bet as well. The worst river in the card, checks behind, he's probably got over cards. Okay, so he tried bluffing us, so actually won a nice hand there. It's got a flat in position there with 10-8. Alright, gotta put some music on. Just trying to think. I don't want to talk too much this session. But let's just see what happens. Let me call there. It's a pair. Alright, hit trips, which is nice. Actually, I should have folded there, but I want to see if I get a spade. Damn. I wanted to see if I could get a spade. It's purely bluffing here. I'm going to call off any bet here. Oops, I should have folded there. I'll actually block a few of his bets here. Alright, so we caught one and lost one. So that evens out, but far out. Alright. I didn't use the dollars, oops. First mistake. So I stacked off someone. Should have folded the aces again. Far out. I'm going to get anywhere, but I can't fold that. Thin value for sevens, but folded. It's a dead board for, so we take, try and take value. At a position I should raise. Oh, we didn't press that. Or maybe I accidentally did. Still a hand, nice. Didn't make the diamonds. Eight a straight here. Oh, he didn't bet it. I was hoping he'd bet. He's gonna fold to any bet that though anyway. We can call a bluff here. What a bluff catcher. Question is, if we bet there, does he call ever? With an ace, maybe? Very thin value. Top two, but he could have King Jack, he could have spades, could have a lot of stuff here. Seems pretty tight, but any king, any spades will win that. Alright, this is gonna be the hand where we get a jam if someone gives us grief. Still could have the best hand here, so I'm gonna call. They always have a fucking nine. Why do they always have a fucking nine? Dangerous board, but get there on the river. So we're sort of bluffing there with jacks. Oh man, gotta stop doing that. These bets are worth a lot. All right, well, the shove is just stupid. Works in tournaments. That's why you cash out. Alright, so if we lose one more Boyne, we're going to be at risk, so we need to get rid of Five and Elegant. No club for King 8. We could check call the river with the kings. He bays me. Ah, fire. Probably could have let go of the river. River bluff. There's no river bluffs there. Need the board to pair up with 10s, or we're going out of 5 and L pretty much. Need some of the jam. We've got the absolute nuts. Nah, we really desperately need this hand. We just really need him not to have sixes. Could have aces here, he's thinking about it. The longer he goes, the more chance he's gonna call. This is what I found anyway. Nah, I really needed a hand, that was nice. Dangerous board. In the end, he could have just had a six and one. If they checked to us, we probably would have thrown a bet in and tried to win that pot. All right, so we got done on the river. All right, switch down to just the two tables now. All right, got 42 backing us up now, but we've got we've got over 60, which is barely enough to beat this level. So I have to be extremely careful then, just not to, we put ourselves in a bad spot, in a dangerous spot there. All right, so now we're just gonna have two tables going, try and concentrate a little bit harder. Got really frustrated with the ace king jam, so I had to go quiet, slowly try and work out the tilt. Just quietly work through it and just understand. Sometimes things just aren't spent for, sometimes advice is good, but not for, sometimes be coming from a background of cash tournaments and back tournament. Not going away with two pair, but snover bets, I'm gonna fold. All right, got a gut shot and two hearts. All right, happy to jam if we have to. Not gonna be scared. Alright, we've got a queen here. Is he gonna jam us? That. I've got a bet here, but he could have a nine. They always seem to have a friggin' nine and then want to call with worse than ace queen. Swear to God. Sorry for the blasphemy. Pocket eights. Wait, I want to see if they've caught the fish. Not quite there yet. Still got 400 to go. Probably won't make it today. Depends if we can stay at this level. You never know. If these two tables kill it, we might be at five. You know, we could be at... There's a couple things that could happen right now. We could absolutely kill it and go and make over $100. We could probably almost lose the entire bankroll and cry. We could lose a little bit more and have to fall back down to 2-0. The most common thing that'll probably happen is to have to fall back down to 2-0. Never say never to, especially making more than enough to stay at 5-0. All right, I got a check raise with the two suitors. Probably could even jam here. I was gonna call actually, because we're actually deep stacked, and if we have a spade, could actually be a really nice spot for us to get all his money in. Okay, this is a perfect hand, just making sure there's no straight flushes. Hopefully he's got king high. Hit a jack on the river. Was really hoping he had a lot of money there, but he didn't. I was really hoping he had a decent hand there, but I think it was folding to any bet anyway there. We opened the bluff up for him. So we gave our chance. Probably should have raised pocket queens. Hope he just calls on the river and that's it. Is that dreaded call on the river again? I'm just going to bet here because I'm sick of people valuing us on the river. They're either going to fold now or... So I'd rather bet now and have some fold equity. Okay, four diamonds. We could probably throw a bet here. He doesn't have a diamond, he's folding. What a call. He had a bluff catcher too, so. It's amazing it seems. I guess it's a common spot for people to bluff at. Got a few turn cards that could be good for us. Seriously. Probably shouldn't have called a 3-bet there. Some people probably 4-bet there, but I don't know about the big blind though. Gave ourselves a chance for a roll flush, but didn't happen. There's some small pots. He didn't 3-bet us. He could have an ace in his range. He could have a 4 in his range. Thankfully, it was a split pot. The ace actually was the kicker. Which is actually pretty blinding. I didn't actually see the... When we both showed, it actually looked like he won the hand. Because the ace was, we were just blind to. I was blind to it. Actually, I should wait on the dealer button as well, just to see who opens. Alright, guys, I apologize. Ace King did work there. We're 1-on-1 with Ace King. I was a bit upset previously. We're gonna run into the top of the range as well. I hate poker sometimes. It's a love-hate relationship. Not again. Go for the steal. Beautiful. I guess we should always go for... Gets under the gun, though. What a day. What a freaking day. We have to steal, don't we? I guess we have to always. Should be the cheap bets. Yeah, the less we risk. And that's what I guess what some of you guys were saying. That's a min bet as well. Probably could have called to the river. He did min bet. Yeah, obviously he's got over pairs there. But if we hit a 6 on the turn or a 7 on the turn, I guess we're stacking him. He could warrant a spot, that spot, I guess. And also on the flop, he's folding a lot of his ace kings as well. Yeah, he hit 2 pair. Did have a flush draw though. Alright, kind of see what everyone's saying. I see what everyone's saying, especially on the... I feel like such an idiot. Oh, I lost... You know... People have fold way so easy. You might as well just put the small bed in to keep still on blind steal. It's just free money. Getting the price of the call there, but... You could almost argue to bet the flop, bet the turn every time. Alright, that didn't work. I was trying to hit his small bet. The worst card ever. Alright, still got there. Whew, dodged a bullet there. Oh, I could have 3-bet there against the cutoff. But more people in the pot, the better, actually, with this hand. Aces get there, nice. Sometimes you get to hit rock bottom to move forward. It's a common spot, isn't it? of get the point, what everyone was saying. All right, so that worked. Didn't think he had the best hand. Not the best hand, I didn't feel like he was strong at the hand at all. No, we're not gonna aim. We're gonna auto fold everything now, like. He was almost argue to play every hand. Would have got the straight in the end anyway. That's the reason why I bet it, if he calls and we hit a gut shot. Would have been nice. I can't believe it. Can't believe it. Can't believe it. That's the first time I've had a word. Well, probably not the first time I've had a word. Just an eye opener. Didn't get there. Wanted the flush. A two pair is very vulnerable. Get a diamond. Probably should adjust the bet sizing there, especially when they do a min bet. Trying to get a cheaper price. Yeah, maybe I should have called. It's the fact that he could have kings, jacks, and tens though. We could have ace king here. Probably lost bay a little bit, but we still won the hand. Excuse me, just making sure. I was just seeing if I had the cam on for this one. Huh. Probably could have called. Let's go with some value on the turn bet. He valued himself on the turn, which is nice. The bluff worked. I bet the Harry's probably got the king. Probably could have bet the king though. Alright, we could call his river bet. So I accidentally folded there. Probably could have checked. Almost can call every river bet. Could almost call from the small blind as well. That's just sad. That's not sad. It's just stupid. 7-6? Are you freaking kidding me? Glad that was a chop. Oh, yes, on the river. We really needed that. Oh, gosh. We called Eddie for the fact that we had over 1,000 hands history on him, and he is quite open. His range suggested he was pretty loose and aggressive. Obviously, he's got two pair there, but pocket queens hold up. Pocket twos are gone. Ah, I said leave this table. Definitely raises us. Okay, so he just does a pure bluff there. Alright, so I'm changing tables purely for the fact is I don't want to have too much on the same table. Go straight there. Have to bet straight. Sweet. Oh, we would hit the straight on the river. Shame they didn't call. Yeah. I just can't believe it. I just can't believe it. Just, I'm out of words. Could have spades. Worry about spades. I guess we have to bet. We can't allow a spade to get in there, but should have bet already. Alright, only slowing down if he raises us here. I have to bet because kind of that diamond. Nice hand there. He's only against a small stack, but we'll take anything at this stage. Two could be in our range here, so we could probably check raise this. Expected to say king there, but had to be a little bit tricky so we didn't get blown off our hand there. Jesus. I am just lost for words, guys. I'm just lost for words. I really am. Didn't want A. Anderson to be in there. I wanted an all-in flip gone though. Mrs. Okay back there looked okay. Alright, how much have we got off the prop? We're at 57. We're gonna easily make it now. We just don't want to go broke, obviously. Alright, there's a dead board. I'm happy to check a dead board. Get him on the river, nice. That was another chip shuffle there. Say he was quite weak. All lost for words, mate. I'm all lost for words, guys, really. I'm just... I could even the phone out even. Got an open ender with a pair. Probably didn't want to bet there, but I've got a lot of fold equity. I'm gonna bet again. If he shoves, we're folding. But we had a straight. The 6-5, good call. He's being 5 cents, really. Please have ace queen and just check. Thank you. Oh, pocket nines. Didn't even need anything else. He was not betting anything there. Yeah, he's not calling any bets there. He might have tried to bluff him though. Penny again. Got an open ender here. He's got his king, he's checking and losing. Got a gut shot. A lot of people might presume that we've got the hand, but the way we played it was pretty weak. Just keeping, purely just keeping the money at risk down. Okay, we'll have to defend our hand here. Get some value against his ace of spades, king of spades. You have to call and then check the river, hopefully. Is he running a bluff here a lot? I don't know. I'm going to fold. Could have jacks there. Could have queens. He didn't play like... He's going to let us know if there was pocket... If he had ace king, though. In position, just going to call here. Hit trip aces. Trip eights, I mean. Actually, gonna leave this table as a bad omen. close that one down, create another one. Hit the nine, has hit the queen though. It makes sense he's hit the queen here. Why else would he call a flop? Alright, so got 10 there, so 10. So back over 70 again. I can call one so get a jack. It's a multi-way pot. Plus we've got a heart as well. Obviously got the back draw, flush draw. Get the free card on the river, which was beautiful. Just didn't get there. Could have bet it though. See if he is going to fold. Steal the pot, nice. Oh man, this is embarrassing. Like, guys, can you believe this? I just can't believe it. I just really can't believe this. Gonna defend ace 8. We could check raise if we wanted to. Power's in our hands. It's just free money, isn't it? It's just free money. And you can even defend from the small blind. That's the sick thing about it. Until they do that, obviously, but we just get out of the way. Just trying to bluff here. It's because I can. All right, two pair with 8-3. I'm gonna value that. Gotta worry about the clubs if he's calling. Hit 110. Probably letting this go. Probably hitting, letting 10-3 go. Nice value hand with trips. Ah, two pair. I don't think 10's getting. Wow. You hit a set there and we lost minimum. I can call with any two and they just fold. He's in position. If they miss, obviously. We have to bet here for value. Also, there's a lot of draws here. They could have a jack and they could be calling, but a lot of times they'll be trying to get that river card. A jacks just folds, it's fine. Could have 3-betted with ace queen, obviously. Not really interested in this hand. He probably wasn't interested. Oh, I could sit on the river too. It's fine. Oh, guys, that's just amazing every time. We could have had the absolute nuts there, but Wizard of Odds. What a name. Nice tasty fishy. Yeah, he's not the. I think he's got an ace. Maybe he's got nothing. Or he's got nothing. Get two pair. Okay. We're wrong there. All right, 57, 770 at this moment. Very nice. Oh wow, would have run out for ace of spades if he had it. No, I'm just gonna let that go. There's no point playing that one. That was a bad run out for tens. Race 10. All right, in position. A lot of good turn cards here. Wasn't one. Yeah, I'm not really good board for 8-3. All right, get all in with him. Chump change. Cutoff could have some trash. Probably should have bet on, they get there on the river. The queen, I believe. Pocket ace was there the whole time. All right, up against Mr. Japanese. Okay, just jamming, get him roll in. He's either got a book or he doesn't. He'd be jamming with king high flushes, I guess, as well. Alright, gonna sit out for a couple minutes. Gee, just need to finish this hand first. But just unbelievable, just this session started off from absolutely being so bottom of the world. Anyway, be back. Alright guys, so we're finishing up now. So it was this amazing session. I mean, we came from, I wanted to keep going, but unfortunately I've got to do some stuff around the house. I'm being summoned by the wife to do some stuff. Anyway, so it's gonna be a distraction if I keep playing, and yeah, you don't wanna be in that spot where you got noise in the background, people are frustrated, and yeah, you just don't want that while you're trying to concentrate. But anyway, going back, what a session. I mean, at the start of the session, you know, we probably did something stupid. We probably put our bankroll at a bit of risk. We lost the ace king flip at the start, and it was looking really bad. You know, we paid off some with trips, with a set as well, a couple of times. I'm all down the dumps. And then we just seemed to tighten up. Seemed to start stealing a lot more blinds, defending from the big blinds, actually playing from the small blind because no one's raising three betting enough of the time. So we're actually just calling from small blind, using position to steal some blinds. This was a great example of a turnaround. Just waking up, just seeing a lot of what people were saying, especially defending with the big blinds. People just aren't defending enough. So we're stealing blinds from the button. We're three betting up against the cutoff. We've got, probably didn't do it so much today, but in the past we found four betting spots as well where we can, you know, you're in the cutoff. You know that the button now is gonna three bet lightly against you from the cutoff. So you can actually, there's actually a four bet bluffing range. And then you know that, funny enough, the dealer could specifically have a five bet shove range there, and it's a light five shove, and it could actually work. So it's actually quite bizarre, but yeah, that's how it could work as well. Another thing is too, you know, when you're in the small blind, you'll get three betted or picked on by the big blind, so then you can actually be four betting lightly and getting a lot of steals that way. So there's quite a few spots. So using position, also there's those still spots as well. So there's a few spots there we've learnt. And yeah, I guess even Donkbet has even got a spot. You know, you can play quite aggressively from the blinds if you've hit a pair and then got a gut shot and all that. We did have that free hand earlier on where the opponent had 7-6. He had the full book where we had trips, but he hit a book. But yeah, you can play quite aggressive, especially with draws from the blinds. And then if you've actually hit your cards, you could probably stack off against someone from under the gun or the low jack, the hijack, sorry, because it's a six table. Hijacks went under the gun if it's a nine table. Anyway, let's have a look at what we've got. I think we're in the mid-70s now. So all in all, it was actually a decent session. So actually we're at $80 now. So it was a good session after such the worst start in history. Thanks for watching, guys. We are currently sitting at 5792. Anyway, thanks guys. Catch you in the next video.